Hi, I'm Bruce Ayers. It's an honor to serve as your state representative. I want to thank Quincy Access Television for the opportunity to address you in my campaign for re-election. I'm proud of my Quincy roots. I grew up here, went to school here, started my business here, and spent 8 years on the Quincy City Council before serving you in the state legislature. During this past legislative session, we've accomplished many things, both in my district and throughout the state. We've passed major bills related to economic development, criminal justice, addiction treatment, seniors and veterans benefits, and other important issues fighting for the residents of Quincy. First, on the issue of the state budget, this year we were able to pass a $41 billion state budget featuring a balanced spending plan with no new taxes. Having a balanced budget allows us to make important investments in education, human services, and public safety. We were able to increase public education funding by $4.9 billion, expanding housing opportunities for veterans, invest in new recovery centers across the state, and improve access to reliable, affordable public transportation. On the issue of economic development, I was able to work with my colleagues for the passage of an economic development bond bill. This bill provides a job creation boost to keep Massachusetts competitive across the country. It includes investments that grow jobs in coastal communities, it boosts manufacturing, supports technology development, and expands career technical training programs. This bill also featured a permanent sales tax holiday, as well as a tax credit for small businesses that revitalize downtown areas. On the issue of public safety, as a longtime member of the Joint Committee on Public Safety and Homeland Security, providing public safety will always be one of my top legislative priorities. We passed a number of bills that support enhanced police training, protections for our firefighters recovering from work-related illnesses, and mental health services for responders recovering from traumatic events. I also worked with my colleagues to create a new fund that provides training, equipment, and programs for our police and cities across the state, giving our law enforcement the tools they need to keep us safe. Working with the Quincy delegation, we also secured funding for additional state police patrols during the summer months to increase public safety in the area. On the issue of addiction treatment, I was proud to join my colleagues to enact sweeping new initiatives that provide prevention and treatment for addiction. This bill focuses on combating the opioid epidemic in a number of new, innovative ways. It takes steps to strengthen community-based prevention and promote healthy behaviors. It enhances the quality of treatment options and places a stronger focus on mental health programs. This legislation allows anyone to purchase Narcan, a life-saving drug and critical in preventing fatal overdoses. It also increases training for law enforcement to respond to overdose incidents. I'm committed to fighting for the necessary prevention efforts that help our communities impacted by this addiction. On the issue of Long Island Bridge, I've filed legislation and I've taken steps to prevent the City of Boston from using any state funding to rebuild the Long Island Bridge. It is fiscally irresponsible for the City of Boston to spend $100 million on a new bridge to an island when a ferry service could be implemented for a fraction of the cost. The money saved could be better spent on expanding programs that address addiction and recovery. We're committed in this fight to ensure that we protect the quality of life of the residents of North Quincy and Squanum. On the issue of being accessible, as a public official, I know how important it is to stay in touch with my constituents. Therefore, I hold office hours every other Friday morning in the district by appointment. If you'd like to meet with me personally to discuss any issue, I encourage you to contact my office. In closing, the city of Quincy is filled with a lot of history and pride. It's a great place to live, work, and raise a family. And it's important that we continue fighting for the necessary funding and services that we're entitled to and protect the values and principles we all share. Thank you again, Quincy Access Television, for allowing me the opportunity to speak with you. And I respectfully ask for your vote on Tuesday, November 6th. Thank you.